Hey guys, Andrei here. Welcome to another video. And right now I'm on Armitage Avenue in Lincoln Park. And this is a strip in the city that is filled with some of the best restaurants, coffee shops, ice cream parlors, you name it, they have it. Living in this location is truly a dream. And today we're touring a property that's in the heart of it all. Welcome to 1963 North Dayton Street. This home has 6 bedrooms, 5 bathrooms, 2 half baths, 5,200 square feet of interior living space, listed for $3.5 million. Development by AK Custom Homes. And a huge thanks to listing agent Azeem Khan of the Khan Group for letting me tour his beautiful listing. Let's talk about the exterior of this home. So right over here, you have heated limestone steps. And of course, in the wintertime, these are very handy. But everything is melting today, so I don't know if we're gonna be needing these until next year. The facade of the property is built using limestone. Very gorgeous, very timeless, and I really appreciate the black railing that ties in with the black window frames and the black Juliet balconies. Now, let's go see the home. Before we start the tour, I should mention that this is a very transitional home that was done with very traditional elements. So a lot of the finishes you see in this home are very elegant and timeless. So the foyer of the home is done using this very intricate mosaic marble tile that looks stunning. And then right over it, you have this beautiful crystal light fixture. Your sitting room in front of the house features an oversized guest fireplace and 2 Juliet balconies that overlook Dayton Street. To my left is the private elevator that actually stops on every one of the levels in the home. And right over here is your formal dining room with this brilliant brass light fixture over it. One of the elements that you'll find on the main level and also what makes this home transitional is this wainscoting. And you find this wainscoting on the main level as you walk into the home. It's very classic and very beautiful. Before I show you guys the kitchen, let me show you this beverage center slash coffee station. I think this area is excellent. It has a sink, which is the second sink in the kitchen. And you have a ton of cabinets that run all the way to the ceiling. And right over here, you have an integrated beverage refrigerator, which is really nice to have. And now, let's see the kitchen. This kitchen screams luxury. It has a very light, crisp color palette, and it has these brass and gold fixtures throughout that make it really pop. I really appreciate the symmetry in this kitchen. So right over here, centrally located, is your range and your hood, which we'll talk about in just a second. And to the left of it, you have your freezer, and to the right of it, you have your refrigerator. This Calcutta Laza quartz look stunning, and they actually vein matched it, and it goes all the way across the backsplash. And then right over here is your 6 burner commercial grade wolf ranch with a double griddle. I mean, just imagine the kind of dishes you can prepare in this kitchen. All right, this hood is a masterpiece. Guys, look at the size of this thing and the workmanship of this thing. And it was actually built by Avenue Metal, which is a metal worker here in Chicago. And they've been making custom metal work since the 1950s. The workmanship is exceptional. I really appreciate the brass band that goes all around. This thing looks solid. And right this way, you have this sophisticated tower of these high-tech built-ins. You have this Wolf drop-down microwave. It looks really cool. Right next to it, you have a Sub-Zero wine cooler. This thing is massive, and of course, it's temperature controlled. And then right over here is your Wolf coffee system. And right over here, you have this gorgeous island. And guys, the first thing I notice is the thickness of the stone and this Calcutta Laza quartz that has these very bold veins. It really makes this kitchen pop. And let's talk about the color of the island. So it's actually iron ore is the name of the color, and it's a very rich shade of gray that I think works really well in this light kitchen. And whether you like to entertain or whether you have a huge family, like, this island is gonna be so functional and so useful. Look how many people you could sit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You could even squeeze 6 people in here. And right over here is the area for a nice table to have breakfast at. And if you wanted to do built-ins, like a bench all around, like really cool custom millwork, like, this is where you would do it. And right this way is your pantry, and all I have to say is that it's massive. It actually goes all the way underneath your staircase. And here's the powder room that services the main level. I really like this powder room. This vanity looks stunning. It's very bold. I really like the matte black wood finish on it with these brass details. And adjacent to the kitchen is this massive family room. I really appreciate this space. This gas fireplace is a statement piece in the family room. It actually takes up like half of the room. It's truly large. And on each side of the fireplace, you have these custom built-ins. So you have some good storage in the base cabinets, and you have these custom shelves that go all the way to the top. And they're perfect to feature your books, art collections, accessories, family photos, whatever you're into, this is where you put it. And this custom millwork continues onto the ceiling, which makes this room stand out even more. I really like this house because it has a very intuitive floor plan. So right off your family room, this is where you go to get to the recreation room, which I'll show you in just a minute. But for now, let's talk about this mudroom and the outdoor space. And here you have your custom built-ins, and these are perfect for storage. And you can have your hooks here, you can store your shoes here. I really like the selection of tile. And one of the best features of this house is the outdoor space. Let's go see it. This is one of 4 outdoor spaces in the home, and it's the largest and also the one that's probably used the most. And this is what you want to have for your summer barbecue. It's this massive grilling station that has a badass grill, it has a refrigerator, it has a soda cooler. I mean, this thing is awesome. And of course, you have a lot of counter space, I should say prep space. So when you're having a party, you can have people over, and like, this is the perfect place to make the perfect steak or hot dogs or whatever you're into. And if you wanted to grill in the winter time, you could. It's just a little more challenging. And before I show you guys the outdoor space on top of this garage, let's talk about this fireplace. This is a wood-burning fireplace. I really like the size of it. It's very dramatic. It's extremely tall. And notice the herringbone pattern that the developer chose to do right in this area right here. It looks really cool, adds a lot of character. This old Chicago-style brick is amazing. It's actually one of my favorite features of this home. And the developer chose to use this brick not just on the garage structure and the fireplace, but also on all sides of the property. This home is solid. We're now on top of the garage, and this is yet another outdoor space. And I'm not even sure which one of the outdoor spaces in this home is the best one, because they're all so unique and so special. And of course, we still have the snow here from the blizzard last week. And today is actually the day where it feels like spring is around the corner, because everything is sort of melting, and it makes me excited because we're gonna be shooting a lot of gorgeous homes in the coming months, so I can't wait for all the snow to be gone already. So I really like this black pergola. It offers a lot of privacy from the neighbors, which is always nice. And I also like the sconces all the way around. They're these industrial sconces that offer light. So when you're having a party and it's late, like, there's plenty of light on this outdoor space. The other thing I'll say is that I like how cohesive these two outdoor spaces are. So when you're hosting a party, like, you can have people down there and you can have people here, and it feels like part of the same space. And whoever said rooftops in Chicago are only for the summertime? And just like in most homes, your lower level is probably the most versatile space in your house. It can be used for entertainment, it could be used to hang out, to relax, and to get some things done, and also this is where you put your guests. And right over here is an exquisitely crafted bar area. And guys, I love the look of it. It's very symmetrical. You have this gorgeous pendant coming down, floating shelves with recessed light, and these built-ins are incredible to have. They offer so much storage, and then right over here you actually have a small refrigerator. And look at this gorgeous faucet. Looks awesome. And this area over here is perfect to chill out and relax. Oh, hey guys. And this over here is the perfect room to make your office. And I also think it's great for a gym. Two of my favorite things to do, to work and to work out. If you wanted to use this room as an office, I think the current setup is absolutely perfect. The desk and the chair are centrally located. It actually has a real CEO office feel to it. And if you wanted to make this room your gym, this wall is perfect to install your gym equipment, maybe some pull-up bars. And if you wanted to use this room as your yoga studio, you also could do that. And this is the powder room that services your lower level. Very clean color palette, nice shade of gray on the vanity, nice light fixture, and of course this floor looks magnificent. And when you have out-of-town guests, this comfy room is where they can stay. This room has everything you could possibly need for your guests. Natural light, excellent closet space, and an ensuite bathroom. Let me show it to you. This lower level bathroom feels like a five-star luxurious hotel. You have this clean vanity with white quartz counters, very nice color, it's like a shade of taupe, and this floor is gorgeous. It's a marble mosaic two-tone tile that looks really, really nice. Huge fan of this marble shower. Marble mosaic floor, marble subway tile on all the walls, marble, 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 lots of marble. And then right over here, you have your sliding shower doors. Okay, we're now on the second level. And on the second level, we have three bedrooms and a laundry room, which I'll show you guys in just a minute. And before I do, let's talk about these hallway floors. These are white oak herringbone pattern floors. And a lot of people confuse herringbone and chevron. So chevron is a zigzag pattern that comes to a sharp point. Imagine the letter V on repeat. And herringbone is actually created by placing rectangles in a staggered zigzag pattern, which is what we have here. Let's start with the bedroom in the west wing of the second level. And this is actually the second biggest bedroom on this level. It's a great sized room, excellent closet space. Look at the size of the closet, it's huge. And right over here, you face Dayton Street, and through these two large, almost floor-to-ceiling windows, you can appreciate the beauty of the street, because this street is very beautiful, especially in the spring and summer when all the greenery is out. And this is your ensuite bathroom. Very sophisticated color palette with shades of beige and taupe. And you have a window right in the bathroom. And here's the shower, and it's actually a really good sized shower. Not only is it long, but it's also very deep. Classic tile selection, kind of in the same family as the tile on the floor. And you have these elegant plumbing fixtures, and you have a nice sliding glass door. Adjacent to your front bedroom is the second bedroom, and it's a really good sized room. It has a nice closet right over here that's actually extremely deep. Look at the size of this closet, guys. It's huge. And right over here, you have a swanky modern fan in matte white. And here's your ensuite bathroom. Again, light. Light color palette. Very classic, very timeless. Hansgrohe plumbing fixtures. You have marble mosaic on the floor. Very nice. And this tub is actually really, really deep. All right, let's check out, let's see how deep it actually is. Guys, look at the size of this thing. I feel small. And centrally located on this floor is your laundry room. I'm really excited to show you the master bedroom suite. So as you walk into the room, on the left, you have your first walk-in closet. And right this way, you actually have your second walk-in closet. Pocket door, you guys wanted to see the closet, so I'm showing it to you. Custom closets, organizers for your clothes and shoes and all that good stuff. So let's go see the bedroom. So this room actually faces east, so you have the most incredible natural light every morning coming in through these three large windows. But what really stands out is the millwork in this room. On the focal wall, you have this custom millwork that goes all the way around and actually overlaps into the crown molding, and then you have more millwork at the top. It's like a tiered look, and there's a lot going on. It's very intricate and impeccable. Who's ready to see the master bathroom? The finishes in this master bathroom are very classic, elegant, and timeless. So right over here, you have one of two vanities in this very light color palette. You have light stone, light vanity. I really like the polished nickel hardware, and they tie in nicely with the polished nickel plumbing fixtures. And notice how intricate these are. So you have these textured handles, and then you have this band around every one of the fixtures. It looks really, really nice. You have oversized sconces that are installed directly onto the mirror, which runs all the way to the ceiling, making this already large room even larger. And right over here, you have the second vanity, and I really appreciate the separation between the two, so you're not in each other's ways in the morning when you're getting ready. I really appreciate the marble tile surround and the fact that you have the plumbing fixture in polished nickel coming off the floor. Very nice detail. And in a home like this, I would expect nothing less than a shower of this caliber and size. Size does matter, guys. This shower is jaw-dropping. So you have an extension of this really beautiful color palette, just like in the rest of the home. You have a tile mosaic on the floor. And on the walls, as well as the ceiling, you have a larger format tile that's actually stacked. Over here, you have two massive shower heads. This is a steam shower, so you have your digital display right in the center. And I love the symmetry of the shower. It's very elegant, it's very symmetrical. Wow, I would take a shower here. We're now on the top level of the home, and this level is incredible. It can be used as your secondary family room, which it's perfect for, or if you want to make it your office, you really could. You could actually wall off the back part of this room and make it your office, or you could make this entire level your productivity room. And of course, right this way is your elevator that does go all the way to the top floor, which is always nice. And here's your bathroom on the top level. It looks very striking. I really like the marble floor that looks very, very expensive, and then the workmanship of it looks exceptional. Matte black vanity, large mirror. I really like the light tile selection in the shower because it actually makes the shower look bigger. Staggered subway tile with matching grout lines, and then you have your hex mosaic floor. It's very crisp, it's very clean. They did a really nice job. And here's your top level outdoor space. And guys, I'm a huge fan of this outdoor space for a couple of reasons. So first of all, part of it is covered, so you can enjoy it in the winter time. And part of it is actually uncovered. So when the summertime comes, like, this is where you lay out, this is where you play, and this is where you soak in the sun. And because this rooftop is east facing, you have the view of the Chicago skyline. Guys, thank you so much for checking out this video. As always, I would love to hear from you. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you thought of this home. And if you love these types of property tours, consider subscribing to my channel. And with that, I'll catch you on the next video. This home has four outdoor spaces, and this one right here is one of four. Can I say something? And it's a place to put your guests if you don't wanna, if they stay with you too long. How about, y'all ready to see the master bathroom?
No. Y'all?
Yeah. And whoever said rooftops in Chicago are only for the summertime?